Checkboxes are a cool way of capturing data input from a user. They're intuitive and can increase the usability of the sheet significantly. I'll show you two different checkboxes in this video. The first one is what we have currently available in all the versions of Excel, and the second one is currently in beta. Let's take a look at both. Here is a sample order sheet with the price of a laptop and its accessories. Let's add a checkbox to capture if a discount needs to be given for this order. I'll go to the developer menu and click on insert. From the form controls, I will select the checkbox. And I will add it to the sheet. Now before I move forward, let me show you how to get the developer menu in case it is not visible in your system. Click on File and then click on Options. Click on Customize Ribbon and ensure that the checkbox for the developer tab is selected. And once done, press OK. Now when we clicked on the insert button in developer menu, we got two checkboxes and we selected the form control option. If you're working on a Mac, you will get only one option and it'll look like this. Continuing with our solution, we have added the checkbox and now let's start configuring it. I will remove the text as we don't need it. Now as I try to select the checkbox, it starts toggling. I'm unable to select it. To select it, I will need to right click. Now I can move it and bring it to the boundaries of the cell B1. Now this looks neat. Right click again and click on Format Control. We need to capture the state of the checkbox in a cell. We need to know if the checkbox is selected or not. For that, I can provide a cell reference in the cell link. I'm going to provide the value as cell B1. It does not have to be the same cell where we have placed the checkbox. But I will do this so that I don't have to remember where I created the link. Now, as I toggle the checkbox, the value changes to true when checked and false when unchecked. However, the true and false in the cell B1 does not appear very nice. So I'm going to change the text color to white to blend it with the background. Now as I toggle, I can see the changes in the formula bar, but not in the cell B1. From here on, everything is very simple. In the cell B6, I will write a simple if statement. The logical test will be B1 is equal to true. This is to check if we want to provide the discount. If the box is checked, we know we want to provide the discount. And if it is checked, its value is going to be true. If that's the case, then in value if true, we will calculate the discount as B4, which is the price of laptop, plus B5, which is the price of accessories, multiplied by 2.5%. And in value if false, which means no discount, we will give the value as 0. Now since the box is checked, the discount is applied. And if we uncheck, then no discount is given. I'll toggle once again for you to see. Checked, we have a discount, 25.6. Unchecked, the discount is 0. So that's how old checkbox works, which is available in most versions of Excel. I will now delete the checkbox and the value we are capturing. We had changed the color of the cell B1 to white. I'm going to change that back to the default color. Now on to the new checkbox. This new checkbox at the time of recording this video is in the beta stage. Hopefully it will be available to everyone soon. Now with cell B1 selected, I will go to the insert menu. I will not go to the developer menu, but the insert menu this time. Click on checkbox and a checkbox is added. Since we have inserted the checkbox in the cell B1, it captures the value in cell B1 itself. We need not set it explicitly. If you see, the checkbox is not selected right now, which means it should return the value as false, and that is what it displays in the formula bar. As I check, the value changes to true. Also, since we've already written the formula in cell B6, the discount functionality also works. We need not write it again. Let me toggle it a few times to show you the difference. Unchecked, therefore no discount. Checked, therefore there is a discount. So that's how simple this new checkbox is. Checkbox are a great way to capture yes-no kind of responses. Go ahead and use them and let me know about your experience. Thank you for watching.